Two independent contractors of the GMA Broadcast Network are sued by a Filipino actor who claims they raped him. One of them is cited in contempt by a Philippine Senate panel probing the case. RG Cruz reports.
Sandro Mulak and GMA Network independent contractors Richard Cruz and Jojo Nones faced off at the Senate just hours after Sandro filed a complaint against them for rape through sexual assault and multiple acts of lasciviousness at the Department of Justice Monday morning. But Senate President Pro Tempore Jingo Estrada got the Senate panel to detain Nones for allegedly lying to the committee on the supposed offer of financial contributions to a charitable institution chosen by Mulak's father. That financial contribution was supposedly mentioned when they met to discuss Sandro's complaint with GMA Network executive Annette Gozon Valdez.
Just the last hearing, yung second hearing po, we were all under oath, and they said that they never offered any donation. They never offered me any donation of to a charitable institution of my choice. But attorney Annette Gozon has proven that they did through an affidavit.
Nowhere in the affidavit does she mention po that there was an offer of settlement, Your Honor. And in fact, she mentioned only the donation to the charitable institution after she put, after the paragraph where she put that she said that Mr. Nino Mulak came from a previous scheduled charity event. No offer po of settlement, Your Honor.
I did not say it's a settlement. You're putting words into my mouth. Mr. Chair, I move that he be cited in contempt.
Before this, the committee retreated to a closed-door executive session to listen to Sandro's narration of events. When the hearing resumed, Sandro Mulak revealed that he was taught to use a powdery substance when he got to the hotel room. This was denied by Nones and Cruz.
Base rin sa investigasyon ko, sinabi ko last hearing yan, parang may powdery substance. Am I correct?
Yes po, correct po. Naglagay po siya ng substance on the table.
Huh?
White substance po.
Naglagay white substance.
White... The table po.
Jojo Nones, you confirm?
No po, Your Honor.
Sino nga nagsisinungaling ka na yata eh? Huh? Base sa investigasyon ko and corroborated by Mr. Sandro?
Hindi po, Your Honor.
What did he let you do afterwards?
Tinuruan po niya ako kung paano po gamitin yung substance.
With a 500 peso bill?
Correct po, Your Honor.
Okay. Can you demonstrate to us right now?
Tinuruan po niya ako paano po gamitin.
Three times?
Yes.
Si Jojo Nones ang nagpupumilit sa'yo. Anong ginagawa ni Richard Dode?
After po ni Jojo, si Richard po yung sumunod na nag-take po.
Nag-take?
Opo.
Yung sumingot?
Yes po, Your Honor.
Hindi po totoo.
Nung pinapasingot ka nitong dalawa, ano nararamdaman mo? Were you high? Nanghina ka ba?
Namanhid po ako, Your Honor.
You lied down in the bed. Am I correct? Correct me if I'm wrong, ha?
Yes po, Your Honor.
And then, when you lied down sa bed, doon nag-umpisa yung sexual harassment.
Hindi po ako nag-lie down. Hinila po ako sa bed.
Sino nanghila sa'yo sa bed?
Jojo Nones po, Your Honor.
You deny?
Yes po, Your Honor. We deny allegations po. Wala po kaming ginawang masama kay Sandro, Your Honor.
Before the hearing ended, Sandro thanked the committee for letting him give his testimony off-site. He also admitted he has not yet recovered from the incident.
Hirap na hirap po ako makatulog. Hindi po ako makakain. Araw-araw po ako ina-anxiety. Tsaka hanggang ngayon po, tiring-tiri pa rin po ako sa sarili ko.
After the hearing, Estrada maintained his belief that abuse did happen, but he chose not to disclose his own findings, saying it is unfit for public consumption. Asked how long Nones will stay in Senate custody, Estrada said that depends on committee chair, Senator Robin Padilla. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.